Follow this umbrella suggests, it is very much to do with holidays and travelling, and in a kind of a relaxed way where you're following the umbrella, you're letting somebody else bring you places and show you things. And as he pointed out, these are like his holiday snaps that you, rather than taking a camera, you take your pad with you to record your memories. But I suppose in terms of when I first looked at these works, the things that I noticed were these very, very grand landscapes or cityscapes like Rome and Greece and St. Petersburg or New York. And it made me think about the Grand Tour, the 18th century, when fantastically dressed 18th century gentlemen from England would go to Greece and Rome to learn about classical civilization. And they would buy up as much of it as they could, or maybe they'd steal it, like Lord Elgin and the Marbles, and cart it back to Scotland to be sold then to the government and not returned to Greece yet. And so these are some of the things that I thought about, was that there is this grand tradition of travel with a specific purpose of seeing other cultures, learning from them. And it's not merely a case of collecting images. It's very much to do with trying to learn how another culture creates images, how it lives with art, how it patronizes art. You think about, for example, the Alhambra in Spain. You're in Spain, but you're learning about a completely different culture, a different way of living in it, the way that a different culture thinks about water and colour, and how wonderful it is that you can see that as something completely different. And then I thought about all of the Irish artists in our kind of modern history, particularly the 20th century, who thought about travel as being completely essential. By that I mean just before the First World War, Picasso and Braque are in Paris. They're inventing cubism. And at the same time, Irish artists like Mary Swansea and Mae Guinness and Eileen Gray are in Picasso's atelier looking at this happening at the time, literally watching modernism be born. And so the other point about travel is that it's so important to learn about the work of one's contemporaries, see what other artists are doing, see what's fashionable, see what's trendy, decide that it's not for you and throw it all out and do something else. And then the other thing that I thought about was the specific places here. The Blaskets in particular speak to me. I'm a Kerry man. And the Blaskets, of course, speak to me of the Leaving Cert and peg stairs, still waking up in a cold sweat at night, thinking that I have to do the Irish paper tomorrow, and that I haven't done my Scotch Gaeltacht. And then you go from there to Mexico, and you start to think about the Aztecs and bloody sacrifice and warm people and delicious food. Then you go to New York before the Twin Towers and 9/11. And you go to Venice and you see the beautiful misty colors of the lagoon. And so what are the things I'm trying to say? Well, it's kind of that David's eye is drawn to these places that are very iconic. As in, these are places that you almost don't need to come to the exhibition. If I tell you, imagine Manhattan, you can. Imagine St. Petersburg, you can. Imagine Mexico, you can. But what has David done? Just with these drawings and these watercolors, he's given us atmosphere and tone and color and noise. So if we see the little picture from the Algarve, which must be in the other room. It's in the other room. You have the people, the beautifully dressed people, going out for their evening passeggiata. They want to be looked at. They want to look. They want to see what's happening. You have the sense of noise and color and the smells coming from the wonderful restaurants. And it's, if you, unfortunately we can't see it, but it's full of primary colors. It's bold, it's noisy, it's active. And then on the other side, he shows us Venice in the early morning. It's misty. It's a bit smelly. The Vaporetto is going past. And he gives us the stillness and the quiet. And it's Venice occupied by nature, by the sea, and by water. And I guess that is David's skill, is that with such small resources, just a pen and watercolor, he's able to give us something that's very, very familiar, but also emotional and beautiful. So well done.
Thank you. Well done. Thank you.
So I declare the exhibition open. Get out your checkbooks. Thank you.